So I have to fill up my gas a lot. The gas gauge doesn't work. It says sometimes that I have a lot of gas and sometimes that I don't have enough gas. And I honestly don't know what it says, so I'll just show you. So right here at 1/4 tank is where the tank is empty. And right here at 3/4 tank is where the tank is full. So when I turn the car on, it's gonna say 3/4 tank, even though I filled it full. So 3/4 tank is a full tank of gas, and 1/4 tank is an empty tank. We'll see how that goes for me for the summer. I don't know. I feel like at one point I'm gonna lose gas, so I wanna buy a jerry can and strap it to the roof. That'll be a video for another day. This is gonna be an expensive summer. So originally my goal today was to end up in Huntsville, and then I realized that—
Turn right onto St. George Street.
And then I realized that wasn't actually on the way to where I wanna go. It was a little bit out of the way. So I changed my destination to Parry Sound, Ontario, which was more so where I'm trying to go. But since I took a little bit longer than expected to leave home today, just because I was saying goodbye to my mom, dad, and sister, I'm not even gonna make it to Parry Sound because I don't really want to drive in the dark. I have this fear of hitting a deer because if my home on wheels gets into an accident of any sort, probably not ideal. So instead, my plan for tonight is to end up somewhere like 2 hours from here on the way to Parry Sound. I haven't changed GPS yet. My plan is just to kind of be like, hey, I'm getting tired. There's a Walmart in about 20 minutes from now, and fall asleep there. She don't want any scene. Taking a little break here, pulled off in this little pull off on the side of the road. I'm contemplating staying here for the night because there isn't any no overnight parking signs, and I did see it on iOverlander. I could stay here for the night, camp out, or could keep making progress, get a little bit further towards Northern Ontario, and go and stay at a Walmart in Collingwood. I'm just worried about if someone would kick me out of here. iOverlander says that it's good, but honestly, I don't really want to get the knock in the middle of the night or anything. By the way, this is the new van. I'll show you it from this angle over here as well. This is the new van. I'm gonna do a tour tomorrow for you, so I'll just do a whole van tour, everything about it. But there is one issue that I kind of need to fix tonight, so no matter where I end up, whether it's Walmart or here, I gotta fix an issue with the fridge. So my potential issue right now is my little fridge right here. So with this fridge, I should be able to plug it into the cigarette outlet, cigarette plug, and it'll turn on, but it doesn't do that. So I don't know if it's just a plug issue and I wasn't plugging it in or pressing it right when I was driving. So I'm gonna check it out now that I'm stopped, and hopefully this fridge turns on. Something just beeped. Oh, okay. Good news. So, can you hear that? So, I had the cigarette plug in this like dual one. So this right here is for my music, and I put it in this other one right here. It must just not have gone in all the way. So, now that it's in all the way, this fridge is turned on, which is good because I can keep all of my food nice and cool. I've got bits and bites, spits, hot chocolate mix, and water bottle with some water in it. So I'm very interested to see how this works. I have to remember at nighttime though to undo these cigarette outlets because they just run whether the car's on or not. Like, there is no keys in there right now, but cigarette outlets still run. So unless I want to kill the battery one night, I have to remember to take everything out every single night for the entire summer. Oh, wow. I can feel this thing getting cold already. Let's play around with it. Okay, so it looks like there's a charge on it. I don't know what the battery means. But right there is a charge. So I think it has to stay plugged in, but maybe I'll be able to unplug it. The battery charges. It's at 29 degrees Celsius right now. I don't really know what cold is for a fridge. 29 degrees, that's hot, is that not? Or is that what it is right now and it's cooling down? And in like 5 minutes, it'll be at 28. I just click settings and it switched between max and eco. I don't think I want it to be on max because I think that'll suck all the van's battery. And one thing I don't want to do is kill the van battery and be stuck here. Right here, if you can see it, it says 29 degrees Celsius. If I press this, it says 2, 1, 0. I can put it freezing, right? So that's what it's going to be. And when it goes back to 29, that's what it is right now. So that's how hot it is in this van. That everything inside of this fridge is 29 degrees Celsius right now, which is like a hot summer day. I think it's 31 outside right now, and it's 8:30, which is insane. We're in a heat warning right now in Ontario, so not the best time to hop in and sleep in a little car. Well, it's a van now. It's not a little car anymore, so. It says it's Bluetooth. It's kind of cool. I don't really think I'll ever do anything with that, but now I'm going to see if I unplug the cigarette outlet and press the power, because it said it was, like, charged. Okay. Nothing happens, so it has to stay plugged in. So my thought is, since I don't have anything meaningful in there right now, I think what I'm going to do is whenever I'm driving, I'll keep it plugged in, because I don't need the reverse camera plugged in when I'm driving. So I'm going to plug it into the reverse camera outlet, make everything super cold when I drive, keep it closed during the night and whenever I'm parked to keep everything cool inside of it. And then just on my drives, it'll cool it down and I don't have to worry about it being plugged in overnight and possibly killing the battery. I think that's probably the best plan of action. We're gonna go with that. One more issue I've gotta fix is if you look at my reverse camera, it's pointed at the sky. So I'm trying to reverse and to make sure I don't hit anybody. I can't see anybody. So let's jump back there right now and try and push it down. I don't know how I'm gonna, whoa. Oh, look at that. I think I can just bend it, to be honest. Okay, I bent it. That should honestly work. I don't think I'll need anything more than that. Boom. We can see the ground. We're good to go. Don't need that on anymore. And I lost my keys. Oh, I found it. After that little pit stop, I'm kind of feeling refreshed in a little way, which means I'm good to drive for another hour. I don't really want to stay here. I don't know what it is. My gut just doesn't feel like it. I feel like that Walmart in Collingwood, Ontario will be good. So I'm going to head there. And then I guess I'll catch you guys at Walmart and show you what it's like to set up sleep at a Walmart. We're turning parking lots into penthouses, people. Found this spot underneath this lamp here. It's a nice little spot. Not sure if you can see it, but there's some mountains in the back there. I don't know if this is where I want to stay, like in this section of the parking lot at the Walmart. Or if I want to head over with some of the truckers, some truckers like way over there, I may head over with them. I don't know, I stayed here a couple years ago and I stayed almost in this exact spot, so. See what I'm feeling. Yeah, I think I'm gonna stay here for the night. I'm gonna edit this video. If you don't know, I'm doing daily videos. So all summer and hopefully longer throughout my travels, my plan is to do a daily video. I don't see anybody doing daily travel videos online. It's something that I was literally looking for. So I'm going to do it. If you think that'd be cool, if you want to follow along for the summer, going across Canada, across America, follow along for the daily videos. Tomorrow, my plan is to do a van tour, show you guys all the ins and outs. And my current objective is I'm heading towards the Rocky Mountains in Canada. So if you're interested in seeing what it's like to road trip from Ontario, like around Toronto, all the way to the Rocky Mountains in Canada, going to Banff, and then eventually Vancouver, Vancouver Island, into America, Oregon, all that stuff. Follow along. There's going to be daily videos. They're only going to get better. I'm pretty new to this, so stick with me. But if you watched all the way to the end, thanks so much. I really, really, really appreciate it. It means so much to me. So I'm going to get some sleep. I'm going to edit this video, and then I'll see you guys tomorrow for the van tour. And who knows what else we'll get up to? Maybe some more stuff. But it's a super cool van. I have so much stuff I want to show you guys. We'll see you guys later.